Hello again. Now we will see the scientific evidence which falsifies the theory of evolution, and we will also see the social implications of Darwinism. The reason why Haruyahi attaches so much importance to Darwinism is Darwinism has been the foundation of the many isms of the 20th century. Now, with the title of Social Darwinism. What is Social Darwinism? Social Darwinism is the adaptation of the law of the jungle to human behavior. The concepts of Darwinism, struggle for survival, survival of the fittest, the strong one survives and the weak ones get eliminated, and there's a constant conflict in the nature which is the cause of the progress. These concepts were taken from Darwinism, the theory of evolution, and were applied in the social sciences, and it has been basic tenets of the many isms of the 20th century. Now let's see of these isms and basic which are have the which have used the concepts of Darwinism. For example, Hitler's deviation of building a master race. Marx claimed that the history of mankind is the history of class struggle. Class struggle, struggle for survival, and there's a struggle between classes in communism. Capitalism provision for the strong growing, even strong at the expense of the weak. Struggle for survival, and there's a struggle between individuals which was applied into capitalism, wild capitalism. Now, for example, communism. Stalin, one of the most prominent dictators, communist dictators, and also one of the bloodiest dictators of the entire human history, he said, "There are three things that we do to disabuse the minds of our seminary students. We had to teach them the age of the earth, the geologic origin, and Darwin's teachings." Yes, he taught Darwin's teachings, and he killed more than 20 million people during his dictatorship, bloody dictatorship. Or Adolf Hitler or fascism, the fruit of jungle, the fascism. Adolf Hitler has taken the struggle between the struggle for survival concept and applied into fascism as there's a struggle between races that are superior races, he claimed, that are lower races. In one of his books, he said, in his book, he said, "Take away the Nordic Germans and nothing remains but the dance of apes." He claimed Nordic Germans are the superior evolved races and there are lower races, less evolved animals. So he caused more than 55 million people were killed during his dictatorship. That's the reason why Darwinism is so important, because Darwinism has been the foundation, so-called scientific support of the many isms, communism, fascism, racism, anarchism, terrorism of the 20th century, and more than 180 million people were killed because of this irreligious philosophy. That's the reason why I have to wage an intellectual struggle against Darwinism, the theory of evolution. Now let's see scientific evidences which refute, falsify the theory of evolution. I want to start with the origin of life, with the complexity of the cells. As you know, living beings are made up of little tiny cells. For example, in an average human body, there are more than 100 trillion cells. Some of them are so small, 1,000th millimeter in size. For example, we see a modern city over here. Take the metropolitan cities such as New York, Los Angeles, Paris, London. Of course, a city like this has power stations. It has high-tech factories, refineries, pipelines, security systems, bridges, highways. If we check one single cell with the electron microscope, we come across a much, much more complex system than the largest city in the world, because a cell like this has a huge data bank. It has nuclear power stations technologically more advanced than the most advanced nuclear power station in the world. It has pipelines. It has security systems. It has seemingly conscious membrane which controls what enters and exits the cell. So a cell which is 1,000th of a millimeter in size is much, much more complex than the largest city in the world. Basically, there is no way this structure, which is 1,000 millimeter in size and much, much more complex than the largest city in the world, is a product of coincidences. It is a very good evidence of creation by an omnipotent intelligence of Allah. Now we see a computer over here. This is the best computer of the world. It's called Cray X1 computer. It is the best human technology can get. Of course, a computer like this has the largest capacity. However, if you check, DNA molecule, which is 100,000 millimeter in size, has much, much larger capacity than the largest computer in the world. And I tell you why. A scientist whose name is Led Adelman, from University of Southern California, he calculated the amount of information in 1 gram DNA molecule. He calculated this to be equal to 200 trillion books. This is more than the number of the books written in entire human history. So basically, that cannot be a product of coincidences. It is a product of an omnipotent intelligence, unmatched artistry of Allah. Now, there are specific molecules in the living beings. Protein molecules. They work as enzymes. They make our muscles, for example. These molecules are very complex. Basically, the mathematicians and the statisticians, they have calculated the odds of one single protein coming into being by coincidences, as evolution theory claims. Remember, evolution theory claims all the living beings, including the proteins, the species, are a product of coincidences. So they calculated the odds of one single protein to come into being by coincidences. This is the number. One chance in 10 over 950. 950 zeros next to number one. This number doesn't have any. The time of the universe starting from the Big Bang is not enough for these reactions. The amount of all the atoms and electrons in the entire universe is not enough. Basically, this number definitely falsifies the theory of evolution because statistically, anything smaller than one chance in 10 over 50, we're talking about 10 over 950 over here, anything smaller than one chance in 10 over 50 is accepted mathematically as impossible. So basically, the whole theory of evolution collapses at the level of one single protein. And after that, it doesn't make any sense to take some skull fractures and engage into speculation whether humans came from the monkeys or monkeys came from the human beings, because whole theory of evolution collapses at the level of one single protein. And there is even more deadly stroke. These reactions would not even start in the nature because there is no error and trial mechanism in the nature. There is no error and trial mechanism in the nature. So these reactions would not even start in the nature, and whole theory of evolution collapses at the level of one single protein. Now you will see on this slide the most prominent evolutionist in the world, Richard Dawkins from Oxford University. He was asked a simple question on this interview to give one single example of the theory of evolution, a positive mutation or evolutionary process. Let's see what his answer is.
Professor Dawkins, can you give an example of a genetic mutation or an evolutionary process which can be seen to increase the information in the genome?
As you have seen, he could not give an answer. So out of the so-called trillions of examples, because there are millions of species supposed to be, according to the theory of evolution and evolutionists, there should be trillions and trillions and trillions of examples of positive mutations and evolutionary processes, he could not even give one single example because there is no example of the theory of evolution. Evolution never happened. Allah created all the species, living beings, one by one, separately, and all of a sudden with his word B. Now, what about the fossil evidence? Fossils are remnants of the living beings which lived in the past, and they're usually bone fractures which are in petrified form. So according to the theory of evolution, there should be transitions from one species to other species. And again, according to the evolutionists, we must have transitional forms, these so-called transitional fossils between one species to other species. For example, in this slide, you see starfish, according to the evolution, starfish evolved into fish over 100 million year old period. If you look at the fossil evidence, you see the fossils of the real starfish and the fish below. We should have trillions of transitional forms. Do we have any of these transitional forms, half starfish, half fish, three-quarter fish, one-quarter fish? No, we do not have one single of these. We have starfish, we have fish. We don't have anything in between. That gives us a very good evidence. Allah created, without evolutions, all of a sudden, the living beings.